Pharma makes the prescription drug OxyContin, which is linked to an addiction crisis that's killed more than 400,000 people in the last 20 years. But the deal does not release any of the company's executives or owners, members of the wealthy Sackler family, in liability.
The unlawful dangerous team put profits over people by seeking to increase scripts for addictive EROs even when they were not medically appropriate and at the height of the U.S. opioid crisis. A time when in Vermont, where I'm from, and across the country, people were suffering under opioid addictions that sometimes ended in death, and so many of those addiction stories began with OxyContin. It is wrong, and we hope that Purdue's guilty plea will send a message that the Department of Justice will not allow big pharma and big tech to engage in illegal conduct that corrupts the doctor-patient relationship.
Shihab Ratanzi is in Washington, D.C. Shihab, is it felt that Purdue is really being held accountable?
It depends on who you ask, but a lot of the people we've asked, right? For a start, that $8 billion figure, it's unlikely to be ever paid. Purdue Pharma is in bankruptcy, so they're expected to be, any settlement will be pennies in the dollar in all likelihood. The Sackler family, who you mentioned, whose name we've seen on cultural institutions around the world, well, the source of that largesse was the billions of dollars they made from marketing falsely, from dangerously marketing and selling OxyContin. They're liable for about $225,000 as a result of this. They keep most of their fortune. When you think about what is being alleged here, that the Sackler family, that the Purdue Pharma Company made a decision in the 90s to market aggressively what a drug which was known to be addictive, an opioid, you know, obviously from the same source as heroin, and market it as a cure-all for all sorts of doctors and pharmacists to prescribe it, which then led to an opioid epidemic, which then also led not just to a prescription opioid epidemic, but a fentanyl heroin epidemic. And this is it, is the question that we're hearing. Just the amount of money that individual states have spent, we were just hearing from someone, you know, on health care, on counseling, on coroners, on adoption facilities and so on as a result of this epidemic, is way more, in the trillions of dollars. This doesn't do it for them. Having said that, there are many other legal avenues still open, and it hasn't also gone unnoticed. And we are hearing more now about the possibility, or at least a suspicion, that the DOJ really wanted to get this deal done before the election to meet a Trump campaign promise from 2016 to hold Big Pharma accountable and crack down on those responsible for the opioid epidemic.
Shihab Ratanzi, thank you very much indeed.